Hi, I'm Duncan McDonald with the Ontario Federation of Labour. I'm briefly going to talk about the Canadian labour movement's struggle against the austerity agenda. The latest episode in that was a very successful demonstration that we had, I don't know if I can see this, on Friday in Toronto here, where we brought out labour and community representatives from across Ontario. I think we're all aware that there's endorsers of the austerity agenda at every level of government, federal, provincial, and local. And one of the tools that they often use is the budget. Because of the deficit crisis, we must cut back on all kinds of programs and cut back on all kinds of public sector employment. Unfortunately, we had both our federal and our provincial budgets happening in Ontario within 2 or 3 days. At the national level, on March the 29th, they brought in a budget that would bring billions of dollars of cutbacks and lay off over 20,000 federal government employees. And the union, the main union in that sector, the Public Service Alliance of Canada, is involved in a massive engagement to protect those jobs and to make Canadians more aware of the importance of these jobs. In Ontario, we had a budget that was really, we called it a banker's budget. They had brought in a retired banker to look at government operations, but not at government revenues. And he came up with about 400 recommendations, and a lot of those found their way into the budget. That will result in massive cuts in the public sector, but also in the private sector, in the non-for-profit sector, because the government funds a lot of these programs. And this is the same at the federal level. At the local level, to use the example of Toronto here, we have a mayor who got elected on the theme of stop the gravy train. But his view is that anything that government is supposed to do to enhance the quality of life in this community, he considers the gravy train. So he has had an ongoing fight with the labor movement and with the broader community. Another thing that the government often want to do in the agenda is they want to get involved in labor relations. And we've seen this at the federal level in Air Canada, Canada Post, and with the Public Service Alliance of Canada. What they want to do is they want to impose their will on the workers, and they say because of the fragile nature of the economy, they can't really be bothered with collective bargaining. They try to impose their will. In Ontario here, the government is really picking fights with a variety of unions in the public sector, trying to say you need to tighten your belt because of the deficit. And at the local level, we have municipalities taking on municipal workers and saying these services are too expensive. Another thing that we're finding is that governments don't see that it is their role to protect the interests of Canadians. We've had a number of examples where multinationals have signed agreements with the federal government, and then they've tried to impose their will on the workers and the communities. Examples like U.S. Steel and Valley Inco with the Steel Workers Union, and as been mentioned by Brother Townsend, the Caterpillar in situation in London, Ontario. Well, they don't see their role of stepping in. In the example of the Caterpillar, the Canadian auto workers received support in the community, but nothing from the government. The government said, well, this is just the private sector. And it's interesting that 36 hours after they decided to close the plant, the governor of Indiana, the state of Indiana in the United States, signed the right to work legislation. So Caterpillar is moving the jobs from London, Ontario to Indiana, and they had asked the workers to take a 50% cut. So we see this austerity approach, and you see it really around the world. Well, there are a number of things that we're trying to do in Ontario about this. At the Ontario Federation of Labour, we are involved in something called We Are Ontario, and this is joining the labour movement and the community groups together to support each other and to build the alliances between us. We have been doing this in the past. This isn't new for us, but we are just enhancing it. And sometimes what happens in this kind of work, you just talk to the already converted. And what we are doing through the We Are Ontario is reaching out broadly across our province to talk to people. And that's why people came to the rally last Saturday. The other thing that we do, and it's often the public sector unions, but I think the entire labor movement has to do it, is to make the public more aware of the positive impact that the public sector has on the economy. This is not money that is lost or wasted. This is money that is invested and affects and benefits the whole economy. Like the Public Service Alliance of Canada is doing with their outreach, we have to make people more aware of the importance of government programs and services and how it affects their community, their families, and their livelihood. Based on our discussions with the people from We Are Ohio, we brought up the Ohio AFL-CIO to talk to some labor people here. From our end, it is very important to have labor unity, where all parts of the labor movement realize the importance of challenging and defeating the austerity agenda. And that's something that we're trying to work at in Ontario. Another thing that we have to do is we have to strengthen the links between what is going on in the community and what is going on in the legislature. That it is important to have positive activity in both these areas, and that's what we are attempting to do here. I briefly mentioned a couple of unions, but I would suggest that the best source of information is to look at these unions, their website, and the ongoing activity that's going on, the labor movement, and a wide variety of community groups in this province, but across Canada. And we are involved today because we think it's important to talk to people and to learn the lessons that from other people, and hopefully through dialogue we will all benefit from this experiment. And I'd like to thank all the people that organized this, because I think this is a wonderful experience. Thank you.